The RAND index is a clustering evaluation metric that measures the similarity between two sets of clustering results by comparing each pair of data points, whether they're in the same cluster or in different clusters in both clustering results. Generally, one clustering result is the outcome of an algorithm such as k-means or hierarchical clustering algorithm. The other clustering result is the ground truth. To compute RAND index, we don't need the data. We need a clustering algorithm's outcome and the ground truth labels. Before we dive into how to compute the RAND index, let me explain why we need RAND index. Let us say that an algorithm gives us this clustering result. That is, the first two rows of the data belong to cluster 0. The third and fourth rows belong to cluster 1. The fifth row belongs to cluster 2. The ground truth states that the five rows of the data belong to cluster 2, cluster 2, cluster 3, and cluster 1, respectively. Since the ground truth is entirely different from the algorithmic outcome, we can say that the algorithm did a bad job in clustering the data points, can't we? No. Actually, the algorithm is 100% correct here. Whichever rows the algorithm marked as cluster 0 are actually cluster 2 in the ground truth. Whichever rows are labeled as cluster 1 by the algorithm are marked as cluster 3 in ground truth. The row named cluster 2 by the algorithm is called cluster 1 in the ground truth labels. That means the clusters found by the algorithm and the clusters in ground truth are the same, just their names are different. Therefore, the clustering matching is 100%, even though label-wise there is no match. Therefore, row-by-row matching between the cluster outputs and the ground truth labels is not appropriate for computing the accuracy of clustering. So what should we do to calculate clustering accuracy? We should use RAND index. To explain RAND index, let us take a different result of the clustering algorithm so that we do not have a perfect match like this one. We will come back again to this 100% matching scenario later. Let us say that the clustering algorithm's outcome is 0, 0, 1, 2, 1 for the five rows. The ground truth, let it be the same, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1. In RAND index, if a pair of data points are found in the same cluster by the clustering algorithm, we call it a positive pair. For example, the third row of the data and the fifth row of the data are in the same cluster as labeled by the algorithm. Therefore, the third row and the fifth row form a positive pair. Now let us take a look at the ground truth of the same pair of rows. Are the third row and the fifth row from the same cluster in the ground truth? No, they are not. Therefore, the third row and the fifth row will be considered a false positive pair. We talked about true positive, false positive, true negative, and false negative before. Let us define them here in terms of pairs of data points in the RAND index context. Let's talk about true positive. If a pair of points are in the same cluster in the clustering created by an algorithm and in the ground truth, then the pair is called a true positive pair. False positive. If a pair of points are in the same cluster in the clustering created by the algorithm but in separate clusters in the ground truth, then the pair is called a false positive pair. True negative. If a pair of points are in two different clusters in the clustering created by the algorithm and also in the ground truth, then the pair is called a true negative pair. false negative if a pair of points are in two separate clusters in the clustering created by the algorithm, but in the same cluster in the ground truth, then the pair is called a false negative pair. We make these comparisons between algorithmic outcome and ground truth for all pairs of data points or rows of data. Then we compute the RAND index as, in the numerator we put true things, that is true positive plus true negative, divided by, that is in the denominator we put number of true positives plus number of false positives plus the number of true negatives plus number of false negatives. Interesting. Notice that here RAND index is actually the ratio of the number of true thingies and the number of all thingies. Can we compute the RAND index for the example we have in hand right now? Yes, definitely we can.